just remember, you all, if you want to be a content creator, you want to tell stories, start now, because it's your opportunity to do that in this 21st century, this Web3 era, all of the social media platforms we have at our disposal. I'm telling you, you could be 7 years old, you could be 70. Start now in your podcast dreams.
Welcome to the Your Podcast Mentor Show with Jonathan Jones. Here you will learn how to start, launch, and monetize your podcast. In addition to hearing the latest trends and the latest and greatest things happening in the podcast industry. Are you ready? What's going on, family, and welcome to the Your Podcast Mentor Show. This is your number one source for podcast news, podcast how-tos, and also interviews. And today we're about to go ahead and dive in. And I have a gentleman I want to go ahead and introduce to the Your Podcast Mentor Show. He's Mr. AJII, and he's the host of the Max Out Time with AJII podcast. How we doing, AJ?
I'm great. Happy to be with you, Jonathan.
Yes, sir. Most definitely, man. Glad to have you here. And I want to go ahead and kick it over to you and give you opportunity, you know, just to give a snapshot a little bit about who you are and just, you know, some of the dope things that you're doing.
Absolutely. Thank you so much. So my podcast is Max Out Time with AJII, which is an interview-based show inspiring and maximizing the success stories of entrepreneurs, entertainers, educators, and the whole nine. Basically, 2 years ago when this pandemic started, I saw how education was upended. Our kids were, you know, left at home having to learn remotely. Our teachers were going through the most of trying to navigate the digital divide and do hybrid lessons for their kids. So I turned my interview-based podcast show, where I would talk to sports athletes and celebrities, from Olympic gold medalists to former NASA engineers, to talking with teachers, talking with students who are currently facing this COVID crisis in the classroom. So in the last few months, I've talked with the Global Teacher Prize recipient, a finalist for the National Teacher of the Year Award, and State Teachers of the Year, and teachers from around the world. So I thank you so much for letting me talk about my education work and the podcast that I've been doing for a few years now.
Yeah, definitely. So what? So I have to ask you, man, what have you found out? Like talking with some of the teachers, like what's some of the high points of just what you found out just dealing with the COVID crisis and that mixing with academia and education?
Well, a lot of them are saying this year specifically, it is the hardest time they've had yet. It is a continuation of last year and the year before, where they were trying to adjust to pandemic teaching. Pandemic teaching, like teaching online, teaching in person, teaching in the classroom with students who don't have vaccines, and kind of the crisis that we are in with learning right now. We have new governments and political regimes who are trying to change education, some will say for the better, some will say for the worse, all across the country. And teachers now, like I said, they are tired. They were like, last year was bad, but this is just compounding. It's getting worse. They are very tired. They have a lack of time in classrooms now, and they're going through it. I've spoken to a bunch of teachers over this month in particular who said the lack of time and the duties that they're being asked to do, substituting other classes, having to drive the buses, and, you know, sit in for other teachers, fill in for other teachers who have quit. The National Education Association came out with a survey recently. More than 50% of teachers are planning to leave the profession before they wanted to, if you will. So a lot is going on right now with teachers, even just teachers who are middle school or elementary, K through 12, and also the State Teachers of the Year who I've been talking to over the last few weeks.
Wow. Okay, so you've picked up this focus and shifting towards like focusing on the education, everything like that. Like, do you have any teaching in your background, or is this something that you ever had like a thought or an idea about, or this is something that you kind of stumbled into just with what's been going on around us?
That's a great question, Jonathan. I don't get asked that too often. My lovely grandmother is a retired teacher from New Jersey in the New York City area. My aunts were teachers, grandfathers, cousins. So I do have teaching in my blood. I have never been a certified teacher or taught in the classroom. during the day and the usual speak. But with podcasting, like yourself, I've mentored students. So some of the students who I've spoken to, some of the students who I've done lesson plans for in high schools and middle schools in the Washington, D.C. area have actually started podcasts of their own. So a class that I've been speaking to often is Duke Ellington School of the Arts, a language and composition class, 11th and 12th graders, basically. They enter into the NPR podcast challenge. It's a huge challenge, over 1,000 participants. And some of the kids who I was teaching and mentoring about podcasting and showing them what I do entered the challenge and became finalists for the NPR Student Podcast Challenge out of Washington, D.C., my hometown. So I do some teaching and mentoring, trying to take after you a little bit as far as the podcasting aspect goes. But that's where my love for educating has come outside of the work that I've been doing at CBS News, where I work and report and produce, and also in the podcast space.
Yeah, that's super cool and super, super neat. So what does it feel like when you work with like a young student, a youth, whoever it might be, and then you introduce them to a world or to a medium that I'm not going to assume that the student that you work with might be, you know, Black, brown, children of color, but just giving that skill set and that knowledge and that information to then see a student's world be opened up and expanded. What does that look like, or how does that feel for you?
Yeah, it's a joyous feeling because these students are facing so much right now, currently. Like I said, last year was so rough on teachers, educators, and education. And if you walk into a student's classroom during the COVID-19 pandemic, it's a Zoom world. It's remote learning, right? So some of them had their cameras off, some of them falling asleep, some of them, you know, talking to the siblings, and mom and dad are coming in and not participating. So then when you bring something to them that brightens up their day, it makes me feel really, really good and empowered. So these students weren't as engaged with the English lessons that they were getting from their teacher at that point in time, but I tried to wake them up a little bit. And I think a lot of them did take an interest in the podcasting because several of them wanted to either be on my show or mentored by me, started their own show. We had private FaceTime calls and things like that. So a lot of them were woken up by the podcast bug that I tried to bite them with.
Yeah, man, that podcast bug will get you, man. That podcast bug will get you. for sure. So I mean, like, AJ, when you're not doing a podcast or when you're not, you know, like breaking the latest and greatest news story, like what do you do to recharge yourself? Because all the topics that you said, I mean, I know you're on the go and I know you're like everywhere and anywhere. So like, what do you do to recharge?
You know what? I am a former athlete, former college football player. I love to work out and kind of work out with my friends and go over a lot of the new ideas and projects that I have going on. My friends, we have this kind of collaborative community. Whenever we're working out or going on runs, they're like, what are you working on? Or what do you think's cool? And they give me ideas, honestly. So when I'm doing pull-ups, when I'm running down to the Lincoln Memorial, from my home, we're just chatting about podcasting and not necessarily work, but just like some of the passion projects and the pivots we can take and the things we're doing in our lives. So I would say exercising and fitness is a big one. I've done podcast series with athletes and on exercising and fitness. And I like to think that I'm still kind of in shape, even though my playing days are about 5 years behind me. So those are some of the things that I do to recharge. And then also, I do listen to a lot of podcasts. I'd say I listen to at least a dozen regular podcasts a week or so, trying to bounce ideas off of the other podcasts that I see. Your podcast, I'm like the third Jones in a row. I saw Anaya Jones, Dr. Fred Jones on your show. So, you know, I don't know what it is. You trying to start the Jones family podcast chain up in here, but I listen to your show as well. I listen to your show as well, and I listen to some news, some fun, some interview-based, just to kind of, like you said, unplug and recharge. But a lot of it still has to do with that bug, that podcasting bug, the storytelling aspect of it, and getting those stories out there.
Yeah. So I want you to, that's funny about the Jones family podcast, but so like for you, you're in an interesting space, right? Cause a lot of people are not in this space of, you have a passion that you're doing, and then the passion and the work, like they collide. And then even when you're self-care, you know, getting a workout in, then the ideas still come. Like for somebody who hasn't gotten to that level or that space, like what, how could you encourage somebody in that if they don't know what their passion is, they don't know, you know, what they could even do a podcast on or whatever, like what would you say to that person? Cause you're in a special spot.
I'm in a special spot. I'm thankful. I've always wanted to do something like this. I remember I took a lot of my inspiration from the Tom Joyners of the radio show back in the day, the Fly Jock, they called him, because he used to travel across the country from one radio station to the next to do his shows. And I listened to him every morning. So that's all the way going back to kindergarten and first grade. I knew I wanted to do something with this. I wanted a microphone of my own. And then as I got to college, I majored in broadcast journalism. I did my first podcast in 2015. And in 2016, I had a radio show and a podcast. And then in 2017, I started this show. So I am very thankful and grateful for those inspirations and these opportunities. But to answer your question, for anybody who doesn't know what their passion is, if it's podcasting or anything else, what I was told a few years back when I was looking for jobs and when I was in sort of a rut in a place where I didn't know what to do, I did what was called a brain dump. Take all the thoughts that you have, all the strengths, the weaknesses, the challenges, the experience that you've ever had, and write them down. Write them down, okay? Then you take the ones that you think you can speak on, that you think you can help people with, that you think you can succeed with in the media, right? Using this content creation space. Take those ideas that you know you can create content on and then stay consistent with it. I was listening to your one with Anaya where you said people drop out of podcasting after about 6 or 7 episodes. I was in a spot like that 4 or 5 years ago. I did 6 episodes without a job where I was looking for jobs. I stopped and I got these interviews at CBS. Thankfully, that turned into my job. But I did about 6 episodes and stopped for about 3 months. I didn't know I was going to go back, but I did. I picked it back up once I started getting under my feet back at work, and I haven't missed a beat since. I'm over 100 episodes now. And although it's difficult with the schedule that I have, believe me, it is difficult with the schedule that I have reporting, producing in the news at CBS News, which is 24/7. I have done over 100 interviews and episodes over the last 4 years, going on 5, and I'm just trying to keep staying consistent and churning them out. You got to be dedicated to it. That's why if you take that brain dump and you take those challenges that you've had, the weaknesses that you used to have, you put them against the positives, you put them against the things that you know that you're good at and you can speak on, then you can take your content creation to a whole nother level. Because you'll be passionate about it. You're dedicated to it already.
That's good, AJ. That's good. You're over there cooking with fish grease right now. You're cooking with fish grease.
Hey, don't talk about that. I ain't had lunch yet, bro. I had lunch yet. You start talking about it, I might get on the DoorDash while we talking real quick.
Oh, man. My bad. Okay, so, man, so you're at CBS News, man, this is something that, you know, we've all grown up and we've turned on the TV and we see like this is like that it station. Like what is it like for you to be literally living out a dream? You said reporting and producing and then even being an award winner, like winning. Just talk about it, man. Talk about it.
Right. You know, sometimes I gotta pinch myself, man. I won Best Black Education Podcast at the Black Podcasting Awards in 2021. Shout out to the Black Podcasting Awards. They've been so influential, you know, with putting my work out there over the last few months. Winning that award, my mom asked you, how does it feel? Everyone asked me, how does it feel? Congratulations. And it's just that feeling of validation. It's the thing that I've been working for my whole entire career. And now I'm giving it back to students. Now I'm giving teachers a voice. Now I am talking with you and trying to mentor the next generation of podcasts. I've got two podcast consulting calls this week as well. I'm just trying to help others, and I'm trying to help others share their stories, whether they're a 17-year-old kid who's going through a Zoom chemistry lab, you know, still during a pandemic, or whether they're a 50 or 60-year-old trying to make a niche for themselves and get into the podcasting space, content creation, because they're either retired or looking for something else to give them joy. And I want to help people do that. So I'm just so thankful and grateful that my training in broadcast journalism, the interviews that I've done at CBS News, helped me do these interviews and talk and share stories so often.
Man, yeah, that's super neat. I mean, it's a super neat just being able to see previous experiences leading to basically helping others like connect their purpose and their passion and, you know, creating like a, I was about to say like a playbook or something for people just to, you know, run the play.
Podcast playbook, you know, so just to use the sports terminology, we got to keep it there. The podcast playbook. I'm trying to push P with the podcast playbook. So that's where we go.
Yeah. So like, what does the future look like for you? Like, where do you want to be with? Because just like what we talked about, you know, you've won the podcasting award, and you know, you're working with CBS News, and you're helping people share their voices. But like, what does the future look like for you? And maybe like 2 to 5 years, what does that look like?
I wish I could say I'd be a metaverse superstar, rock star, or someone like that in the Web 3.0, but I don't think I'm there yet, Jonathan. I got to do more of my research. But as we progress in 2-5 years down the line, I really do want to help other podcasters, like you said, and mentor them and see their growth from high school, from college, or from, you know, their businesses podcast, and go further and further with that. As like a coach, you know, I love doing that sort of thing. Another thing I want to do, I want to make this Max Out Time with AJ2 a podcast network, a podcast, you know, entity, a channel that is helping other podcasts. And I can share their podcast through my newsletter and through my network. So I'm just really trying to share those stories the best way I can. I think of myself as a self-described story crafter. So everything I'm thinking about all the time, whether I'm listening to a podcast, whether I'm editing a podcast, whether I'm talking to somebody or doing a story at CBS News, I'm crafting the next story. So I want to help you all craft yours as well.
A story crafter. Wow. Man, that's good. That's really good. Huh. Okay, fair enough. So when thinking about, you know, in the line of work that you do and everything like that, what would you say was one of the most encouraging interviews that you've done? I don't want to say the best, but I want to say like the most encouraging, just, you know, with some of the conversations that you've had, because I know you've had a lot.
Encouraging for me were definitely the interviews I did during the beginning of the pandemic, April, May of 2020, June of 2020. And I was doing a series called Sports Suspended. So if you remember in March, everything paused. If you remember the NBA games, they canceled it on the spot. You know, I think it was Wednesday, March 11th or March 12th of 2020. So I gathered people in the sports industry, athletes, coaches, and anyone who was involved in sports in some way, did a series of podcast interviews because I knew that sports had been suspended. They weren't doing their sport right then. They didn't have their job to go to every day. And we talked about the mental health decline and what it was like where you don't have your sport. I talked to a top pick in the WNBA draft in 2020. I talked to a Pro Bowler in the NFL who, again, were just kind of sitting at home training or getting in group calls with their teammates. But one person in particular, her name is Britt Waters. She was the in-game host for the Washington Wizards basketball team and also the Washington Mystics women's basketball team. Shout out to both of, you know, my hometown teams. And she was telling me at the end of my podcast, you know, she was thanking me for, you know, the opportunity to come on the show. And she said something really interesting. She said, you're sharing people's stories, and that's the greatest impact of them all. And as I'm doing a transcription on the show and I'm thinking about that and how I can help others in podcasting, it didn't hit me until weeks or months later that she was right. Sharing others' stories, contents, each one, teach one, helping the world grow, helping the podcast world grow, helping the world in the pandemic grow. Just seeing a story, you know, on FaceTime or on IG Live during the beginning of the quarantine pandemic helped somebody. I guarantee you, because we were stuck in our houses, we were isolated, and people just wanted content, things to engage with. So that stuck with me. That was an eye-opening quote that she left me with 2 years ago. Sharing stories is the biggest impact of them all.
Yeah. AJ, you on a roll, man. Oh, no, no more food references. No more food references. My bad.
I'm telling you, if you give me another food reference,
My bad. Okay, so we're going to get ready to wrap this up so you can get lunch in just a minute, man. Just a minute. So let's say that there is a student, right? And they see you on CBS News and they're like, I want to be there. A student or a young adult. What would be the first step that you would tell them that if they want to be to where you are, what would be the first step to tell them you need to go ahead and fall in line with this?
So this is going to apply for a very, very long time. See this right here? See that? Cell phone. You got your cell phone, social media, got your laptop, got your web 3.0, got all of your content creations at the tip of your fingers. Okay, so you get on your TikTok, you make your short reels on IG, you tell your stories that way, take it into your own hands. Start doing it now. One of the most special podcast guests that I've had was a 9-year-old. Fourth grade girl who ran 2 podcasts, was a sports commentator for the WNBA and the NBA, all while going to fourth grade, and started an IG Live series during the pandemic. She started doing interviews of WNBA players when she was 6 years old. Now she's not even 11. I think she's 10 years old now. Start now. Just start now. If you're passionate about something, you have a cell phone, you got internet connection, you got TikTok, you got them reels, don't do the TikTok challenges at school, but do them, you know, in your free time and create that content. Go out and tell the stories that you want to tell, however you can do it, because you can put it out there just as quickly as CBS News, ABC News, and NBC can do it.
Man, there it is. Get started now. Mm-hmm. All right. So now I want to bring it to this segment. I like to where we have a little bit of fun, right? A little bit of rapid fire. And this segment is called This or That. Okay, it's called This or That, where you're gonna pick one option or the other. So AJ, are you ready?
Born ready.
All right. Here we go. Cake or pie?
Cake.
Jogging or hiking?
Oh, you know what? I'm going to go with hiking. I got into it a little bit during the pandemic because there was nothing else to do. But I'm going to go with hiking. But if I'm going to run, I'm going to run. But I'm going to go hiking.
That's fair. Hamburgers or tacos?
Hamburgers.
Money or free time?
I'm going to go show me that money.
And if you go to the movies, are you gonna eat? You gonna eat popcorn or are you gonna get candy?
Oh, popcorn, definitely. Lots of butter.
All right, man. There it is. Yeah, there it is, man. There it is. I'm about to do a real quick commercial. And I'm about to come back to you for the final word. Absolutely. Okay. So everybody out there, for my speakers, for my coaches, my consultants, I want to invite you to go to getpaidwithpodcasting.com. This is the number one community to not just help you start, grow or even monetize a podcast, but this is how you will be developed as a podcaster. So go to getpaidwithpodcasting.com and sign up for our free training. Now back to AJ2 for the final word. What you got for us, AJ? What you got for us?
Man, I just want to thank you for being the podcast mentor, and I see all of your posts on IG. That's where I see them all. I know you're on every single platform, but I see them on IG. I've been watching your episodes and the guests you've had on, these amazing folks with podcasts who are in this space, cultivating this space. I saw you in the Black Podcast Report, you know, last fall as well. So just keep doing your thing. You're speaking the conferences. Thank you so much for allowing me to share my story. And, you know, I'm extending you an invitation to come share yours as well at any point in time with my audience. And just remember, you all, if you want to be a content creator, you want to tell stories, start now, because it's your opportunity to do that in this 21st century, this Web3 era, all of the social media platforms we have at our disposal. I'm telling you, you could be 7 years old, you could be 70. Start now in your podcast dreams.
There it is. Family, this is the Your Podcast Mentor Show. We're going to have all of AJ's information down in the show notes. And I want to just remind you all on the Your Podcast Mentor Show, where we help you establish your platform so that you can profit on purpose from your podcast. Until next time, peace. God bless.